Hello, CIS scholars. I'm Mamita More, your science educator. I welcome you all for our second session of science. We have started the topic number one, changes around us. And we have seen reversible and irreversible changes. There are different kinds of changes that occur in our day-to-day lives. And broadly, we classify these changes as reversible and irreversible changes. Now, let's see what is the definition of reversible and irreversible change. If the object that undergone the change can be brought back to its original form again, it is called reversible change. And if the object that undergone the change cannot be brought back to its original form again, it is called irreversible change. Okay, so whether after the change, whether we are going to bring back the object in its initial or original form or not, the changes are classified as reversible and irreversible changes. Now, let's see further properties of this reversible and irreversible changes. In reversible change, no new substance is formed. There is change in the appearance of the object after the change. What is the meaning of appearance? Appearance means how does it look? And there is no change in its composition. Composition means content. For example, melting of ice. Now here there is a picture of ice. Now ice is made up of water. If we want to make ice, we put the water in ice trays and we keep it in the freezer. And then it turns into the ice. Now if we take the ice out, what happens? It starts melting. Okay, and after melting, it becomes water only. So ice is solid form, but when it melts, the water is in liquid form. So here, ice before melting and after melting, does it appear change? Yes, its appearance has changed. But as it is made up of water, water remains as it is. It means there is no change in the composition, but there is change in the look or in the appearance of the object. We can see here in the picture the ice cubes of solid and how they are looking after the melting in the liquid form. Okay, so in the reversible change, no new substance is formed, there is change in the appearance of the object and no change in the composition of the object. Now let's have a look of irreversible change. In irreversible change, what happens? We are not going to get back the original object. Okay, so it's a permanent change and there is formation of new substance. New substance is formed in the irreversible change. For example, making yogurt by mixing milk and curd. Here we can see the yogurt. Fine, and it is made by mixing milk and curd. Now, from this yogurt, are we going to get back milk again? No, milk was the initial substance before change. But after undergone the change, new substance yogurt is formed. So, irreversible change is permanent change and there is formation of new substance. I hope scholars, you have understood these properties of reversible and irreversible change. Now, in next session, we'll talk about solutions and thank you.